We start with Jessica being followed by an animal looking like her dad Ben. Actually, it was just a bad dream. So the animal changes into a spider before Jessica awakens in her bed. Jessica is an award-winning author for children book series. Jessica is married to Max and stepmother to his girls Alice and Taylor. Alice has gotten along well with Jessica, but not Taylor. The family moves into Jessica's home where she grew up, but had to leave after the incident with her father as a kid, where he attacked her. Follows the voice to where she discovers a teddy bear, which is Chauncey. Taylor sees a strange woman looking at her from her window. When Taylor goes out, she meets a boy named Liam, which is a neighbor. Liam tries to invite Taylor over to hang out, but all of a sudden Jessica interferes. Taylor is upset and rushes into her room. Jessica and Max find it cute that Alice has an imaginary friend at her side. Then an older woman arrives and introduces her name as Gloria, and her being Jessica's babysitter when she was little. Jessica tries to remember hard, but does not. Now at night, Jessica sees and hears Alice and the imaginary bear having a tea party, but the door is half closed. Then she hears Alice telling a person that she looks pretty. She was actually Samantha, the mentally ill mom of Taylor and Alice. She attacks Jessica. The police are present now, and how Taylor tells the truth to her dad, that she messaged her mom because she thought her health was improving, and Jessica puts Alice in bed. Now in the morning, Jessica's husband Max has to travel, and leaves. Now Jessica has to look after the two girls. Alice plays a game of scavenger hunt, along with Chauncey. And, on the other hand, we see Jessica secretly going to the nursing home to visit her father, Ben. He is at the nursing home, since he has lost control of himself. With the happening of the attacking incident and Jessica tries talking, something happens to him.
I looked into the eyes. Oh, he's talking to CB!
Daddy, what's CB, a radio?
And he grabs Jessica's wrist.
Yo, CB!
Daddy!
And she leaves. We see Taylor invite over Liam now, and Alice doesn't really like him. Liam brings some stuff, which we find out is his mom's allergy tablets. Liam goes to Max's alcohol area, and says no since it's her dad. Alcohol. Liam accidentally breaks a bottle. Liam goes to get some towels to clean up, but he sees the bear. Then it turns into a huge scary bear, making Liam fall being frightened. Jessica comes back home and she sees him over, and talks to his mom and is angry at Taylor. Jessica sees some drawings of her, having been cut out, and believes it's Alice. She goes to Alice's room and tries to talk and explain to her, but has a realization she is talking this whole time to the Chauncey bear. And finds Jessica's scavenger hunt list, which has some horrid things, such as to do something that hurts. Alice is about to do something horrifying. She sees a flower, but it's actually a nail on a wooden piece, and is about to put her hand. All of a sudden, Jessica is there and pushes it away. Jessica calls psychologist, to talk with Alice. She begins to record the interaction, and sees Alice speaking to Chauncey, which is unfriendly and has hostile behavior.
Maybe we shouldn't play together anymore, Chauncey. Be friends! No.
And says Jessica is fake mom. Talking in private with Jessica, the psychologist Dr. Soto, states not seeing a bear. Then Jessica asks Taylor if she saw Chauncey bear.
What? No, he's imaginary.
Jessica has a realization that Chauncey teddy bear was seen to her and Alice only, and how no bear exists in the house. Dr. Soto plays a video of a boy who also had an imaginary friend, and had bad things happen to him just like to Alice, and it's saying never ever. Later on, Alice vanishes after talking to the Chauncey bear. Taylor and Jessica go search the house and outside, and Taylor puts the blame on Jessica for Alice being missing, and her life went downhill after Jessica came into their lives. Taylor again goes out, and sees Gloria, Jessica's babysitter when she was little, and tells Taylor to go to her house, and states that Chauncey was also the imaginary friend of Jessica, when she was a kid, but something happened after her dad Ben, had interfered and went crazy. We see Jessica looking through her old things, and finds a drawing she made of a location named, Never Ever, and she draws over the letters she did as a kid in her room. Now Taylor and Gloria arrive to the home to Jessica, and they have a realization that they have to play the scavenger hunt list being, to go to Never Ever location. Jessica grabs many items for this. The problem arises at, when the something that hurts shows up on list, Jessica uses scissors to stab her hand, and gathers everything in a bowl and puts it on fire to burn, but nothing occurs. Then all of a sudden Jessica angrily tells Taylor that it's all her fault for Alice vanishing, since she didn't look after her own sister.
Jess, you're the reason Alice is missing. You're selfish, Taylor. Like your mother.
Taylor's feelings are deeply hurt by this, and this technique worked. Jessica only said this to have true pain. Door opens to the Never Ever location. They go in the Never Ever world, controlled by imagination of children present. Gloria was super happy since she knew now she wasn't
now
crazy.
Now I know for sure.
It's incredible.
So happy for you, really.
While on the lookout for Alice, they came across room, which showed the exact night of the attacking incident, when Jessica was a kid, and why Ben went crazy. Turns out Ben actually got her out of the Never Ever world, but Chauncey tried to grab him back into the world. Then Ben looked into eyes, which made him go crazy, and he did this, just so that his daughter Jessica would be protected. Gloria closes the door, which they left open. She did this because she has a delusion and illusion, and is obsessed with the findings and all of the possibilities that could be present for many years. We see Chauncey Bear scary and big as hell, and shreds Gloria, ending her chapter. Later on, Jessica and Taylor find Alice, but she is in a room with her blood mom Samantha there, but she is not real. Alice has gifts all around her. Jessica and Taylor have to convince Alice that anything there is not real. Jessica opens a door to escape into the real world using the color blue. They successfully convince Alice that it's all fake. Then Chauncey Bear tries to attack, again being big and scary. Taylor and Alice leave the room. Jessica stabs the bear, and is with Alice and Taylor now in the real world. We see Jessica takes her husband Max and the two girls to meet her father Ben at the nursing home. But all of a sudden, Jessica has a realization she still is in the never ever world. Chauncey Bear wanted to lure Jessica using Alice. Chauncey states that Jessica will never leave and stay there forever. Suddenly Taylor arrives. Chauncey turns into a big spider. Then Jessica and Taylor escaped, and try closing the never ever world door, but Chauncey looks at her, and Jessica sees into his eyes. She almost was about to go crazy just like her father Ben. Alice sees lighter fluid present, and puts fire, and putting the evil behind them and in the never ever world. They leave the home, and the house is ruined by all of the fire. Now we see Jessica, Taylor, and Alice go to a type of hotel, are shocked and scared seeing a teddy bear, but come to find out it is of a kid. The young boy tells having an imaginary friend, and moments later, the look of the bear is the same. Chauncey. In conclusion, evil is real, and don't trust someone so much that you will regret it later, and don't let your imagination get a hold of you, and not be obsessed with something so much, as it might be too good to be true, since Gloria died, and now Jessica, Taylor, Alice, and Max will move on.